reviews about people just completely disliking the ending or like cliffhanger or not completing the series, completely explaining or that you left certain people to go a different direction. Will you ever finish the book, or is there finish at a later time? You know, kind of go back to it, maybe explain some loose ends, or.
First of all, I'd like to say whoever has the 1990s X-Men cartoon theme song as their phone ringtone is awesome. that's a flashback to my high school days. Second, the Stormborn series had to wrap up for contractual reasons, and so I made an edgy decision to give it a somewhat inconclusive ending. I thought people would appreciate the artistry of that, and they did not. So the short answer is I would like to go back. I would love to keep telling stories about every series I've done. If I, could write a million pages a day, I'd be doing spin-offs about Carter from the Georgina series. I'd be doing, more about Eugenie and Dorian. I would do all sorts of stuff. So I'm hoping if I get a break, I can, knock out that fifth book in Eugenie and kind of.
I was really reluctant to buy it, but I finally bought it today, so.
You can still read it. Some people, I shouldn't say everyone doesn't like it. There are a lot of people actually who will tell me, you know what, that was the perfect way to end it. You might be that person. Or you might send me an angry email, and that's cool. We're still friends either way. Check our time. We are good for a couple more. Let me make sure. This slide, you're so quiet. No questions? Got my eye on you. No? Down that end? Okay, it's this middle section. Go ahead.
What can you tell us about the Vampire Academy movie? Have you been on set yet, or do you have plans for that?
The Vampire Academy movie, yes. I hope your calendars are cleared for Valentine's Day next year, because
they are.
That's release day, so make your dinner reservations with your sweetheart or your best friends, and get ready. Vampire Academy movie is currently filming in the UK, and it's fantastic from everything I've heard. The cast is having a fantastic time with it, which I love. I would hate to have an awesome movie that everyone hated making. And so it means a lot to me that they enjoy it, they really seem into their project. And I actually, this actor, his name I didn't recognize right away, tweeted oh, I heard Richelle might come over and hope she can see us. And I was I don't even know who you are. And I looked him up in IMDb, and he's a real tiny, tiny role in the movie, but they're all so excited, everyone who's a part of it. And they did a great job casting. There was no generic, oh, she kind of looks blonde, let's cast her. I mean, they did very deliberate auditions. They cast well-known people when they needed to. They casted unknowns where they did the best. And I think it's pretty great. And if you're not familiar with the director and the writer, they are brothers, Mark Waters and Daniel Waters. Mark Waters directed Mean Girls, and Daniel Waters wrote Heathers. So they both have a background in dark teen stuff, and this is the first project they've ever collaborated on, so that's pretty cool, too, that it's kind of a family affair. And let me see what else I can tell you. The script is pretty true to it. When you sign away those movie options, you really are signing away your rights, and I was fully prepared to, walk into a theater and watch a werewolf army picture, that no longer even resembled my book, I signed it, that's my own fault. But it's very true. They hit, the important points in the book. He gets the humor, he gets the emotion, he got all that in, so I'm really, really, really thrilled with that. And, let's see, as far as a set visit goes, there is plans for something like that to be happening later this summer. So we don't have dates on that yet, but
cameo.
No, people ask me that. Do I want a cameo? I don't know what I could do. I'm 36. It would be 21 Jump Street if I was walking. Say Vladimir's. Narc on them. Who's that woman? So I don't know. I'll just be happy to see it. I have seen exactly one still from the production, and it is the scene in the attic where Christian and Lissa first meet. Ooh. And it's just beautiful. It's actually, and this is the reason I write books and they do the movie stuff. The setting is just more beautiful than I could have created, the way they've done this church attic, and they're on opposite sides of the room, and it's just iconic. It's just beautiful. And so, that one scene gave me chills. So I'm super excited to see what they'll do with the rest.
I have two questions.
Okay.
Is the Game Board of the Gods romance?
There is a romance in it. It's a dysfunctional romance. Dysfunctional seems to be like a key word in my books. It has problems. It has problems, certainly, like all my romances. But yes, there's romance in there. I wouldn't say it is a romance, exactly. Not yet. Give it a couple books. Like all mine, it's a slow burn.
Oh, yeah, and then the second question. Most of the books that I read, and then they make movies, they messed up, the book, because, they miss important details. Are you okay with it if they miss, important details of Vampire Academy?
I am, and it's because I know what I was getting into when I signed it away. Would I love it if they got all the important details? Of course, and I think they do, based on the script that I saw, provided it hasn't been, revised since they showed it to me, and now it is a werewolf army picture. I think they got the important parts. It's just, they're two different mediums, and it's so impossible for them to ever be exactly alike, and that's why so many, as you guys well know, many books to movies just don't work. They just don't translate. And sometimes you get awesome ones, sometimes not. Got my fingers crossed we're in the awesome camp, but I'm willing to take what comes. It doesn't change the books. People will say things like, oh, aren't you worried it'll ruin the books? The books, they aren't changing. They're not going to be magically rewritten if, something happens in the movie. So I still have that control, and we'll still go forward with that. Okay. I'm going to do your question, and then we're going to wrap up.
This is about Vampire Academy.
Mm-hmm.
Did Rose really love Adrian?
Did Rose really love Adrian?
She did.
Cheap. What answer do you want to hear? You want the answer to be yes.
I want it to be no.
No.
No. It's Dimitri, not Adrian.
Cheat. Well, I think I have to be careful here in case anyone hasn't read that far. I would just say her ultimate choice, I think, answers that question. Where her feelings lie.
Okay, good.
If you'd like to discuss that at length, you can ask me at the signing table. And if you have other questions, you can also feel free to ask me at the signing table. Before we get to that, though, did everyone get a blue ticket?